This video will show you how to adjust the clutch on your StrongArm electric winch made by the Dutton-Lainson company. However, this process does vary depending on the style and features of your StrongArm winch, so mimic the following instructions only when your particular winch is described in the top left corner of the screen. In order to adjust your winch's clutch, you must first remove its cover. If you have a DC winch with a remote, you should see a pigtail coming out of the back of the winch. Use a standard set of pliers to pinch and pull the strain relief bushing out of its hole, then remove the bushing from the cord. If you have a DC winch without a remote, simply pull the switch and the attached wiring harness off of the cover side. Before you remove the clutch lever, place it in the engaged position like this. Let the spring do the work, don't force it. Now, to take off the clutch lever, grab a number 1 Phillips screwdriver, completely loosen the two screws holding the handle in place, then pull the handle and its screws off of the winch. Notice the position of the square lug on the side of the plastic spring keeper. If the lug is positioned in this general area, the clutch does not need to be adjusted and your winch should be working just fine. If it's positioned in this area, however, proceed with the adjustment process by grabbing a 3/8 inch wrench and using it to loosen all 4 bolts in the corners of the cover. Pull apart the front of the cover and lift it off of the winch. If your winch is AC powered, remove the 3 motor wires from the frame clip on the side of the winch. On both AC and DC models, we recommend simply leaving all of the winch's wires connected to the cover while you adjust the clutch, instead of having to disconnect them now and reconnect them later. Your first step when adjusting the clutch is to remove the clutch spring. Grip the spring keeper with your left hand to keep it in position. Be sure that you keep your fingers away from the spring. Use a large flathead screwdriver to pry the end of the spring out of its hole on the winch's base. The spring will snap violently, so be sure to keep your hands and the rest of your body clear when you remove it from the winch. Next, use a small flathead screwdriver to rotate the O-ring so its small cutout portions align with the 4 pegs on the clutch spring keeper, then lift it off of the spring keeper. Keep the spring connected to the spring keeper as you lift them off of the clutch handle nut and set them aside to be reinstalled later. Unthread the clutch handle nut in a clockwise direction. It's a left-hand thread. Then remove it from the clutch stud. Pull the outer thrust bearing and the races on both sides of it off the stud, followed by the large gear, finger spring washer, small gear, and inner thrust bearing and races. If you have an SA9000 or 12000, there will be 2 spacer washers still on the stud. Just leave them there. Now you should check the condition of the 2 thrust bearings. If they are noticeably worn, dry, or burned like you see here, they should be replaced with new ones. Sandwich 1 of your new thrust bearings between 2 races and slip them onto the stud. Slide the small gear onto the stud, followed by the finger spring washer, then the large gear. Depending on when your winch was made, a rubber clutch pad will be found on one side of either the small gear or the large gear. Just make sure that you reinstall the gears so the pad is between them. Insert another new thrust bearing between 2 races and put all 3 of them on the stud. Screw the handle nut counterclockwise back onto the stud until it's finger tight. Place the spring keeper and its attached spring back on the clutch nut with the square lug at about the 3 o'clock position. Then push it up slightly so it's sitting closer to a 2:30 o'clock position. Get the O-ring and position it so its cutout portions do not align with the lugs on the spring keeper. Grab a pair of vice grips or pliers, firmly grip the end of the spring not connected to the spring keeper, then maneuver the spring until its end fits back into the small hole near the winch's gears. The tension in the spring will probably make this difficult, so adding some grease to the end of the spring or using a hammer may be necessary. Be sure to once again keep your hands away from the spring when you're reinstalling it to the winch. Before you reassemble your winch, make sure that the clutch has been adjusted correctly. To do this, place the clutch lever on the spring keeper. Rotate the lever clockwise and then back counterclockwise, again letting the spring do the work. Do not let the lever snap and do not force it. Remove the lever and check the position of the rectangular lug on the spring keeper. It should still be approximately the 2:30 o'clock position. The only thing left to do is to reinstall the winch's cover. Open it up and set it on top of your winch. If your winch is AC powered, slip the green, white, and black motor wires back into the frame clip on the clutch side of the winch. Now, a very important note, your winch could experience a serious electrical malfunction if any of these three motor wires are hit by the winch's gears that spin during normal operation. Because of this, be absolutely sure that you tuck the motor wires into the very corner of the cover, as far away from the gears as possible, when reinstalling the cover on an AC winch. If you have a DC-powered winch with a remote, ensure that the red connector fits back into its cutout. Next, grab the two long cover screws and use your 3/8 inch wrench to screw them into the corners of the clutch side of the winch. Then get the two short cover screws and tighten them into the opposite side's corners. If your winch is DC with a remote, reposition the strain relief bushing in the same place on the cord that you removed it from, then pinch the bushing back into its spot on the back of the cover using both your pliers and fingers if needed. To reinstall the clutch handle, look for the biggest hole on the handle and the biggest hole on the clutch. Line them up, press the handle onto the winch, then tighten both of the handle screws. Lastly, on a DC winch without a remote, push the switch and harness back into place on the clutch side of the winch. Thanks for watching. Please like this video, subscribe to our channel, and let us know what product or process you want to see in a future Dutton-Lainson video.